see if there, see if there's a demand for that job, like, how far out, that way, if you want to, like.
See if there's a demand for it?
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
I got a question, so what do you do, and what do you do in a situation where an employer, potential employer asks you, what did you make at your last job? Like, when they try to get your salary information for your last job that you had? I mean, it's easy for us now, because we're Marines, and we're most of what we get paid all in, so we go and look at it, but say we get a job after the Marine Corps, right? So we wanna upgrade positions to, you know, get an executive level job. They ask you what your salary was before, and how would you respond to that?
So a lot of times in interview, like, when you're filling out an application, sometimes it'll actually say, like, they want your previous salary on there, especially for federal jobs, they actually say permanent for the previous salary. If I'm trying to, like, upgrade, because it sounds like for you, you're afraid that they're gonna be thinking, like, well, I'm gonna give you just that, or a little bit more, right? And you're looking for a bigger upgrade?
Yeah, it's kind of a cop-out for a company to undercut your pay compared to what people, like, in your same office, you know, they got hired on around the same time, you are making $10,000, $12,000, $15,000 more a year, but because you put your salary information down in a lower amount, or you were honest with them, said, yes, this is what the salary was, we're going to cut your salary and give you a lower amount.
I would go with, I always try to flip it on the other end and get them to put a number first. And as part of negotiation, they're trying to get you to throw a number in first, right? They want to know your salary so you can kind of figure out on their end what you have to work with. I've never been asked, like, no one has ever personally sat down and said, like, what did you make at the last job? No one has said that. They've asked me, like, what do you need to make? What are you looking to make right now? And then they want me to throw the number down first. And what I do with that in negotiation, you want them, negotiation 101, to say throw the number in first when you know what you're working with. So you want to do your research and know what the going rate is for that person, that position. And then you want to throw in the years of experience that you have or some other kind of value that you can bring to the table. But if someone, I guess now if someone asked me that when I made my last job, I would always talk about my last salary, and then let's say I would probably add in, like, additional income from other things I do to really jump that number up. I'd be a creator, though, probably said that, to make that number be higher. Or I just turn it into, I flip it and talk about what I'm looking to get moving forward.
Probably do that, because I wouldn't get the past salary.
Some things are going to require that, though. So federal hiring, if you ever, is anyone here interested in federal hiring, federal jobs, you have to put the previous salary down. It's part of a requirement of the application process. So then you just need to argue your case about what it is that you want to make going forward. You're leaving your job, you're hoping for an increase, right? There's a reason you're leaving it, trying to slow down.
One tactic that was explained to me, of course, I'd say college, I went from working at one factory to working at the other one, and that block where they said, like, what your previous salary was in that class, it was like, leave it. It's not a federal job, leave it blank.
That's what I do too.
And because they said you can use that as a conversation starter, because a lot of times the interviewers are going to go through everything else, and then they get the wrap up, they're like, oh, by the way, I saw that this was blank. Well, they already know everything else about you, they already know everything that you run, everything you're capable of. So when they come to that, that's what you in my case, I can't remember exactly what they were, something like, you know, you pay $18 an hour, but we were working 65 to 85 hours a week, and the duties that we had were actually above and beyond what was sold to us, and we learned how to deal with it, but it was unfortunate to get paid less than you should have, because you were doing this job plus another job. And that wound up being, I think that job, the last job was 18, the new factor I got a job at was 22 an hour just because of having that conversation with them. Because they hired 8 of us at once, and me and another guy were talking in the break room, and he was getting paid 18 an hour, and I was getting paid 22 just because I left the blank, and he put the GBA 18 in the previous job.
Oh, so it actually
held
him back.
Yeah.
And that's
what you're trying to get at.
Yeah.
So you would probably, I guess, with Matt's advice, would leave it blank. But I know that sometimes, guys, when it comes to, like, filling out applications, leaving things blank can also come up as, like, you're not following the directions. But if it was me, I would leave that portion blank. If I was filling out that, and if someone asked me about it, like, what did you make in your last job? I'd say, well, I'm looking to improve for my last job, and what I'm looking for moving forward is this. So I would turn it around and say what it is I want. Alright, so when it comes to researching your career, there's a lot of things that you need to consider. Maybe you want to look at a place because you might want to move in the future. So you might want to find a company that has multiple locations, and you're checking out where they do services. So you're looking at their website. Their website is where you're going to find all the information. A lot of times jobs are posted on a main search engine. So when you go into a company's website, sometimes they'll only post jobs on their website because they want it to be tailored and catered to those that are actually actively on their website. So when you go on a website, usually you find the career section at the bottom of their website. Usually they're not in careers and you can look to see what jobs are posted. You can find tons of information about their organization, their competitors, all that stuff. You really need to look at their website and go through everything. Like a fine-tooth comb. You need to do your research for yourself on your own end. Think about it this way. It's so crazy to think about that, like, think about a TV, right? You would do all this research to find a TV, right, that you want, or something that you want to buy. You look it up all these reviews, spend a lot of time trying to figure it out, but when it comes to your life and what you're going to do with your career, no research, makes no sense. That's your life. That's something that you're going to do every single day. I would research like crazy to make sure it's a good fit for me. What I would do is I would even research to make sure the job is even posted. Call somebody and say, like, hey, I saw this was posted. Is it still available? Where are you at with this process? I would research to figure out, if I even want to work with a team, figure out who's going to actually be on my immediate team. Stalk them on Facebook, look at their stuff, see if I even like those people. Do I want to spend time with them? The number one reason why people actually leave their job is what? Because they hate their boss. That's usually why. So I want to research my boss like crazy, make sure I'm actually going to have a good relationship with that person. I can tell a lot about someone and see if I'm going to jive with them by looking at their social media. By what they say, how they act. So if you really value your time, you're going to do the research like crazy and make sure it meets all the needs that you have. Before I'm going to do that before I'm even going to apply to the job, before we spend hours on it. So another thing that is good to research is the company's reviews. So for me, you can do this on Glassdoor. So on Glassdoor, this is going to be your main site to look up salaries and reviews and anything about the company. So let's look up company reviews. So for me, this is just my personal thing. I'm not being serious. I don't want to work with a company that has under a 3-star review. Of course, I'm going to read people's reviews because there's always those people that are complaining about everything about life. But I'm going to look and see. There's a general thing going on and it's below 3 stars. I probably don't want to work. So you can check out those reviews. There's salaries there. You find a bunch of company information. It's one of my favorite sites to search for those kinds of things.
So I think with today's society, we use social media so much, and that's our way of interacting, emailing, through texting. So when you pick up the phone and actually call somebody, it's that old natural way of communicating. So they can hear your tone of your voice, and kind of like get a flip for your personality over the phone. Makes it a lot easier. So when they do see your application, they're like, okay, I remember serving that person. They kind of had like a good vibe, and they can go from there.
And do they stand out? Because no one else is going to call. Most people don't. So you already stand out in that way. And another reason is, let's say, you want to write a cover letter, and in your cover letter, you want to actually address the person by name. Because whenever you can, you should be addressing them by name. Because we know that people like their names, so you should find their name. So a lot of times, you're not going to find out their name. You see a job posted, you don't know who's the person that's in charge of that job. So you need to do your research. So you want to find ways that you can connect with them. You want to figure out who they are, so you can look them up and establish that, think about how you connect with them before you walk into the room. So a way that you can find out who they are is to call the organization. Do you know who's in charge of that program? They do. It's so-and-so. And you can look them up. So that's one reason why. So you can search for them later so you know their name. And you can even simply call and say, I wanted to write them a personalized cover letter and I wanted to see if I could get their name. And they're like, yeah, cool. This is their name. Then you get to look them up. So that's a good reason in fact finding calls. It's a good reason to call just to see if the job is still posted. Remember we talked about how sometimes it's a formality. They post jobs and they already have an idea of having it filled, or they just filled it. You saw it's been posted for 2 weeks. So you might call and say, like, I just was curious where you guys were at with that process. And then you give information. And then it's your opportunity to connect. When I used to hire therapists and things like that, I used to just wish that people would call me. I'm like, man, make yourself stand out. You go on the company's website, you see my name, you see that I'm in charge of the program. You can Google me at any time. My actual office number is there. My email address is on the company's website. If you're applying to a job, why are you trying to go through the HR? Find me. Email me directly. Send me your resume. It's there for you. No one did that, ever. And if someone would have, it really would have stood out to me. It would have showed that initiative. And I know that sometimes you can think that maybe you're bothering someone by doing that, but this is how I see it. As I see it as, like, I think about myself, and I think about how I would love it if someone did that. It shows initiative to me. And honestly, if someone is bothered by the fact that I'm trying to pursue an opportunity with them, then they're not someone I want to work with. Right? So I highly encourage you to stand out and be willing to call. And the other thing is, you know how, like, have you guys ever had to, like, have a conversation, call someone, and you felt, like, uncomfortable? And let's say, like, you're sitting there, and you're like, hold on, and you're feeling, like, has anyone ever dealt with that? And do you notice, though, like, you're so much more brave to do it when you're, like, having an awesome day, you're with your friends, and you're just chilling, and they're like, hey, call them. And you're like, okay, you just pick up the phone, and you're like, hey, not a big deal. It doesn't even bother you. It just flows out naturally. But if you sit there and get in your head about it, and you make yourself all anxious and nervous, it's, like, so hard for you to call. So what I suggest is what I like to call alignment before action. Get your mind right, get yourself feeling good, and from that feeling good place, you create amazing results and success. So you can do that when it comes to calling. Anthony?
In the aspect of research, I know a friend, she was in customer service, and what she did was kind of advanced people calls, like, their, like, customer service, like, department.
Yeah.
To see, like, how they were, like, operating. And when she went for her interview, she kind of gave, like, her aspect of how she could improve the company and, like, in that department. And they saw that as more progressive and taking initiative on how she can help them.
So they liked it?
They liked it.
Yeah, that's interesting that she did that. People, like, if you come in, because you see enough people so much that you're already willing to kind of, like, show that you can do that work. Who asked me yesterday about a portfolio? Someone over here? About bringing a portfolio with you. And you were getting at kind of showcasing your previous work with them?
Sure, because, I mean, like, our JST and our VMAT, like, that kind of really goes into a lot more detail of, like, the different pieces.
When you show it to them, yeah, so you visually see it.
I mean, stick that on, like, a resume, it's going to become really long and tedious, but a portfolio, I mean, and somebody can actually flip through, especially somebody that, if you're looking to transition to a job that's the same specialty, but
Or, like, what if you design, like, let's say you design a program, or you show that you can do something, you have visuals with you that can show them. It's kind of like what she did. She's already kind of shown that she did that work in advance and came with suggestions for improvement. I think that makes you stand out a lot. And for me, in the past, what I've done is I've carried stuff with me to show that how I've been able to analyze data, reports I've done, program designs and models I've had. And I didn't, like, wasn't, like, taking over the interview and being like, here, let me show you all these things. It was like when they asked about something, I'm like, oh, yeah, I have a great story for that. I'll tell you. Actually, I have a document. Do you want to see it? And they'd be like, yeah, show me. And every time I've done that, I've gotten jobs. But I've seen other trainers out there actually tell people you don't do anything with you. So, I don't know. You might hear it different from someone else, but I'm telling you, I think it serves you. Because a lot of us are visual learners, and we do want to see proof of what you've done. All right. Does anyone have any questions about calling or anything like that, research? Do you understand why it's meaningful and helpful? So what I'm saying is, when you guys think of, like, networking, remember we talked about how it's all these different people you can network, from the people that are just work there, from people that know people and all that. Honestly, the best person to know is the person that is, like, the secretary of the main person making the decision. That's one of the best people to know. So building a relationship with them. In fact, a lot of times during interviews, they will ask the secretary, like, if you had an interaction with the secretary and you walked in, or some other person of them, or their other staff, they will ask them, hey, what did you think about that person? They probably really value that person's opinion. So be friends with that person. Get on that person's good side because they actually have a lot of power. So call that person. Find out information from that person. All right, so now we're moving on to... Do you guys need a break?
Sure.
Yeah. We'll take a break.